fly score revenge? Why did the chicken cross the road? And what kind of adventure lays an egg? It's time to dial up the old school love as we get ready to break down the best classic console games of all time right here, right now on Filter. I'm Mizoda, and welcome to Filter, a hand-picked top 10 video game countdown is voted on by you, the viewer, at g4tv.com. Everybody remembers their first time, and whether it was an Atari 2600, in television, or any one of a number of old-school home consoles, the day you finally got your hands on one is the day that your life would change forever. And although the classic games that dominated your early days of play are now nothing more than sweet pieces of nostalgia tucked away in the happy cracks of your brain, their importance will never be forgotten. That's why today we're here at the Classic Gaming Expo in Las Vegas, so that we can pay respect to the games that got us started. But before we get started on the countdown, let's hear a few people reminisce about the good old games.
I'd say some of the major games that helped gaming move from the arcades to the home were the Miyamoto creations like Donkey Kong and Mario Brothers.
You could say that coin-op conversions were the thing that helped games move from the arcade to the home. But there were some games that stood out, I think, games that were not really coin-op conversions, but games that stood on their own and distinguished the 2600.
Went to Atari with the idea of building a device to connect to your home TV that would let you play the arcade games in the home. And that first game was Pong.
My first console game was an Atari 2600.
Like a lot of people my age, it would have been a Christmas present.
Got an Atari 2600 for Christmas.
I was at home on Christmas Day playing Air Sea Battle. That was the game that came with the original Sears telegames. We didn't get combat. All my other friends had combat.
What you describe as an old school game was really the state of the art in technology at the time that it existed. You had to concentrate on gameplay. The game had to be fun or you weren't going to try to sell it.
Okay, before we begin, let me eliminate all confusion by pointing out that today's countdown is limited to games that got their start in the home market. That's why you won't see any games like Pac-Man or Dig Dug. You will, however, see games like Mega Mania. Matter of fact, you'll see that one right now because the Space Invader-style shooter starts our countdown at number 10.
Mega Mania, good game from Activision. It was real manic, more of a Space Invaders kind of game, but things went from left to right and everything, up and down and stuff like that.
What really made the game unique was that the objects on screen were common items that you may encounter in your daily existence. So we're talking like flying bow ties, flying tires, unusual funny objects.
Space Nightmare, it's basically a shooter. It's kind of a Space Invaders, Galaxian inspired type of deal.
A lot like Galaxian, except cooler.
Good graphics, better than it was average on the Atari 2600 at the time.
While the tires in Mega Mania were out to get you, the tires in our next game were out to get you there ahead of the pack. In Enduro, you were a race car driver in the National Enduro, a long-distance road race, and you had to pass a certain amount of cars each day on your way to capturing the checkered flag. Sure, games like Turbo and Pole Position were more fun, but you couldn't play those at home, could you? Enduro grabs the 9th spot.
Enduro, good racing game, smoother graphics and scrolling and everything than the other driving games for the 2600. And of course, traditional Activision style was high quality, good gameplay.
The designer was a nuclear physicist, I believe, and he designed two games, and we've never heard from him since.
You were racing at night, you were racing on the ice, you were racing in the rain, you know, that part made it interesting, and it was always challenging. Great way to waste large amounts of time on a good driving game.
When Enduro was first released in 1983, Activision offered a membership to the Roadbusters Club and a free patch to anyone who could survive for five or more days. But if you were a real hero back then, you didn't need no freaking patch. All you needed was a copy of our next game and a buttload of free time. Take a look at rescuer extraordinaire Roderick Hero in the game at number 8, H-E-R-O.
The most interesting thing in Hero has to be that it was actually a vertical maze. So to do that, of course, the character had to be equipped with a helicopter backpack to be able to go up and down.
Best Atari 2600 game ever. Best ever. It's a phenomenal game, tons of things to explore, very challenging, way ahead of its time. Really, really advanced game that stands up today against whatever you can put out, on Xbox, Dreamcast, anything.
A little FYI, H-E-R-O actually stands for Helicopter Emergency Rescue Operation. A little more FYI for you, I still have my old home console, an Atari 2600. What about you? When we come back from the break, we'll find out what happened to your gateways to gaming. Plus, we'll keep counting down till we crown the classic king. Can a road-crossing chicken muster up the courage to grab a victory, or will he get caught in the crosshairs of combat? Find out when Filter returns. Welcome back to Filter. I'm Diane Mizoda here at the Classic Gaming Expo, counting down the best classic console games of all time. The rankings for Filter shows come directly from the responses you post on the G4 website. To make your vote count, log on to g4tv.com/filter and select the Filterator. Then choose a category, vote on a scale of 1 to 10, and we'll take care of the rest. While you're there, be sure to post your suggestions for topics and games you'd like to see covered in future episodes. Let's get back to our 10-to-1 adventure with the game at number 7, Adventure. The Atari classic lands on the countdown for two simple reasons. It's the first RPG-ish game ever, and it also had the first Easter egg ever. But here are a few more reasons, just to keep it real.
Adventure was a game that launched a genre, and that's what made it so significant. It was very simple. It was a 2K game.
And at Atari, Warren Robinette looked at the 2600 and said, I think I can make this, an adventure-like game on the 2600. He tried to put a dragon in the game.
The dragon kind of looks like a duck.
And with the limited graphics, the dragon ended up looking kind of like a duck.
It's all about the dot, about the sword, and about spearing the duck. What else is there to do?
Talk about defining the 2600 in its own right, creating a new genre, and doing an adventure. Super significant game, I think. Good choice.
You looking for a real adventure? Try being a chicken and making your way across 10 lanes of screaming vehicular mayhem without getting turned into a poultry pancake. If you play the game at number 6, you know exactly how hard and how much fun that could be. Here's Freeway.
Freeway, avoiding the cars with a chicken, which I think was inspired with David Crane going to Lakeshore Drive in Chicago.
I looked at that and I said, well, there's an idea for a video game. Guy trying to get across 10 lanes of traffic. We had a little bit of a problem. What happens when a man gets struck by a car? Jim Levy, president of Activision at the time, he said, hey, I got an idea, turn it into a chicken, and we'll tell the story of the chicken crossing the road. In the last 24 hours of the development process, I turned the man into a little yellow chicken.